Now let's see about intermediate code for flow of control statements, or SDT. SDT means syntax directed translation of flow of control statements into three address code, or SDD. SDD means syntax directed definition of flow of control statements into three address code. We know what are flow of control statements. These are nothing but control statements. By using control statements, we can transfer the flow from one state of the program to another statement. So the examples for control statements are simple if else, else if ladder, nested if else, switch, for, while, do while. So likewise, we have several control statements. So in this concept, we are writing this intermediate code for three control statements, such as simple if else, and while loop. So here we are translating those three control statements into some intermediate code, or we are writing some syntax directed in this concept. So we are writing intermediate code for three control statements, such as simple if else, and while loop. So that means we are translating those three control statements into some three address code. First, let us take the first one, that is nothing but simple if. Let the statement here is S produces if of B, then S1. Here S and S1 are nothing but some statements. B stands for a condition, a Boolean expression. If this expression is true, then S1 will be executed. If this expression is false, then S1 won't execute. Now let us write the code for simple if statement. So code for simple if. Code for simple if. So this is our production here. S produces if of B, then S. So this is nothing but our production. So let us write the code for simple if. Here first we have to evaluate this condition. So this condition is evaluated with the help of B.code. Here B.code, the Boolean expression may return either true or false. So B.true stands for true label. True means 1. Whereas B.false stands for false label, that is nothing but 0. Okay. So here B.code may return either true or false. So if it is true, then B.true label will be executed. If it is false, then B.false label will be executed. Here if the condition is true, then what will happen? S1 will be executed. Here S1 is nothing but the code for S1 is S1.code. So S1.code will be executed. Okay. And after that, what will happen? The next statement will be executed. The next statement of S1 is nothing but S1.next, or this S.next also. Because whenever the condition is true, then the body of if will be executed and the control comes out from the if. The next statement after if is nothing but S.next. Here there is no difference between S.next and S1.next. Both are same only. So if the condition is true, this body will be executed. After that, this statement will be executed. This statement can be called as either S1.next or S.next also. So if the condition is false, then what will happen? The control comes out from the if. So the next statement will be executed. So the next statement is nothing but S.next, or we can write as S1.next also. Next we have to write the semantic rules, or three address code, for the simple if. Semantic rule. So first what will happen here? First, we have to B.code will be executed. It may return either true or false. So first one, B.true is equal to. So if the condition is true, then B.true will be executed. So it generates a new label. So we have to call a function called new label function. Here new label function generates a 3 address code for b dot true. So here if the condition is true, then what will happen? The body of the b dot true will be executed. So what is the body of the b dot true? S1 dot code. So S1 dot code will be executed. So after that, after executing S1 dot code, what will happen? After executing S1 dot code, what will happen? The next statement will be executed. So what is the next statement here? The next statement is nothing but S1 dot next. S1 dot next is equal to. So what is the next statement here? The next statement is nothing but this statement. S dot next. S dot next. Okay, next, if the condition is false, if the condition is false, then what will happen? This one will be executed. Here this is a simple if, so this b dot false is optional. Here there is no need to write b dot false. If the condition is true, then this block will be executed. Otherwise this block will be executed. So if the condition is false, then b dot false, it is optional. If you want, we can write also b dot false. So b dot false. So if the condition is false, then b dot false will be executed. So b dot false is equal to b dot false is equal to. So what is the statement that is to be executed? Yes dot next. So here the code that is to be evaluated is, here what is the left hand side non terminal? Yes. So yes dot code is equal to. So first what will happen? B dot code will be evaluated. So b dot code concatenation, that is denoted by byte symbols, two byte symbols, logical R. Next, after that what will happen? A label is generated for b dot true. Here always if the condition is true, then only this body will be executed. So we have to generate the label for only b dot true. Whereas if you take if else, then if the condition is true, then S1 will be executed. If the condition is false, then S2 will be executed. So we have to generate label for true as well as false. Here there is no need to generate label for b dot false. Why? Because whenever the condition is true, then only this body will be executed. So b dot code will be executed, and after that we are generating the label for which one? B dot true. B dot true. If b dot true is true, then what will happen? S1 dot code will be executed. S1 dot code will be executed. So in this way we can write some syntax directed definition or syntax directed translation or some intermediate code for this prediction. Okay, so if it is syntax directed translation, then it is better to enclose semantic rules within curly braces. Okay, next let us write for if else. So let the production is same one, S produces if of b then S1, if of b then S1, else S2. So this is our production here. So if the condition is true, then S1 will be executed. If the condition is false, then S2 will be executed. So let us write the code for if else. Let us write the code for if else. So first what we have it? First this condition will be evaluated. So we can evaluate this condition with the help of b dot code. So b dot code may return either true or false, either true label or false label. So true stands for 1, false stands for 0. So if it is true, then b dot true label will be executed. If it is false, then b dot false label will be executed. Okay, now let's see how it will be executed. So if the condition is true, then b dot true will be executed. So control goes to b dot true. Then what will happen? S1 dot code will be executed. So S1 will be executed, and after that what will happen? The control comes out from the if else. So the next statement of if else is either S2 dot next or S dot next. So what is the next statement of if else? Either S2 dot next or S dot next. Here let us write the last statement as S dot next. So S1 dot code will be executed, and after that we have to go to S dot next. So without checking any condition, go to S dot next. So why we are writing this statement? If we execute this statement, then this false block won't execute. Directly the control will goes to the next statement after S2. The next statement after S2 can be written as S2.next or S.next. Okay. Whereas if the condition is false, then what will happen? S2.code will be executed. S2.code will be executed. Here there is no need to write go to S.next. Why? Because the next statement after S2 is S.next only. Okay. Now we have to write semantic rules. So let us write the semantic rules now. Okay. So let us write the semantic rules. Semantic rules. So first what will happen? If the condition is true, then B.true will be executed. So in order to store the result, it generates some three address code instruction. So in order to store that result, let us generate a label with the help of new label function. So B.true is equal to new label. Okay. So if the condition is true, then what will happen? The control goes to B.true. So S1.code will be executed. And after that, what will happen? The next statement is S.next. Okay. So S1.next is equal to. So directly the control goes to S1.next is equal to. So what is the next statement here? It goes to S.next. S.next. So after executing the body of the S1.code, the next statement of S1 is nothing but S.next. Next one. If the condition is false, then what will happen? B.false will be executed. So B.false is equal to. So here it generates a three address code. So in order to just generate that one, we are calling a new label function. So if the condition is false, then what will happen? The control goes to B.false. Okay. So here what is the next statement here? Okay. What is the next statement here? S2.next is equal to. S2.next is equal to. The next statement after S2 is nothing but S.next only. So these two are same only. So S2.next is equal to S.next. Next, let us write the code here. What is the left hand side non-terminal? Yes. S.code is equal to. So first we have to write the code for this Boolean expression. So B.code, we have to evaluate that one. Concatenation. So after that, what we have to do? It may return either true or false. If it is true, then a label will be generated for B.true. So label of B.true. Concatenation. So next what will happen? If it is true, then what will happen? S1.code will be executed. S1.code. So after executing S1.code, then the control goes to S.next. So that is done with the help of generate of go to what is the statement? S.next. So for space constraints, I am writing in multiple lines. Okay. Just we have to write all these statements in a single line. S.next R. So what is the next one? So with this B.true is over. Okay. Next, if the condition is false, then the control goes to B.false. So what will happen now? We have to generate a label for B.false. So label of B.false. Next, we have to evaluate the code for S2 also. So S2.code. So in this way, we can write intermediate code or semantic rules for simple if and if else. Now let's see for the next one, that is nothing but while loop. Now let us write for while. Let here the production is S produces while of B. While of B, then S1. Here S and S1 are nothing but some statements. B is nothing but a Boolean expression, that is nothing but a condition. If this condition is true, then this S1 will be executed. Now let us write the code for Y. Code for Y. So first what will happen here? First this expression will be evaluated. So we can evaluate that expression with the help of B.code. It may return either true or false value. So it may return either true value or false value. So if it is true, then B dot true label will be executed, that is nothing but 1. 2 stands for 1. If it is false, then B dot false will be executed. Okay. Now let us write the code here. If the condition is true, then S1 dot code will be executed. And after that, what will happen? So first S1 dot code will be executed. Next, once again, we have to check the condition. Okay. That is nothing but while loop. If the condition is true, then this body will be executed. So once again, we have to check the condition. If the condition is true, then once again body will be executed. So once again, we have to check the condition. So likewise, the body will be executed as long as the condition is true. So we have to go to B dot code. So that's why let us place a label here. Let the name of the label is begin. So go to begin. Go to begin. So what will happen now? If the condition is true, then S1 dot code will be executed. Next, go to begin. So once again, the condition will be checked. If it is true, then once again, if it is true, then the body of S1 will be executed, and once again the condition will be executed. So whenever the condition is false, then the control comes out from the while loop. So the next statement, that is nothing but S1 dot next or S dot next will be executed. If the condition is false, then B dot false will be executed. So the next statement after S1 is nothing but we can write it as S1 dot next or S dot next. Now let us write the semantic rules. The semantic rules for this production. So first we have to create a label for begin. So begin is equal to new label. Begin is equal to new label. New label function. Next, B dot code that will be executed. So if it is true, then what will happen? B dot true will be executed. So for B dot true also, we have to create a label, because if the condition is true, then a 3 address code instruction needs to be created. A label needs to be created. So B dot true is equal to new label. So then what will happen? The control goes to B dot true. So S1 dot code will be executed. So after that, what is the next statement here? The next statement after S1 is S1 dot next is equal to, we have to go to begin label. So S1 dot next is equal to begin. Next, if the condition is false, then what will happen? S dot next will be executed. Okay. If the condition is false, then S dot next will be executed. The condition is false, that is denoted by B dot false. B dot false is equal to, so what will happen? S dot next will be executed. Now let us write the code here. B dot, what is the left hand side non-terminal? Yes. S dot code is equal to. So first what will happen? A label is created for begin. So label of begin. Concatenation. Next what will happen? B condition will be evaluated. So B dot code. Next what will happen? Condition will be evaluated. If it is true, then B dot true label will be created. So label of B dot true, B dot true concatenation. So next what will happen? S1 dot code will be executed if the condition is true. So S1 dot code will be executed, concatenation. So next what will happen? We have to go to the label begin. So generate, go to, we have to go to begin without checking any condition. Just directly we have to go to there. Next one, if the condition is false, then what will happen? This S dot next will be executed. Okay. So what will happen? S dot next will be executed. So that code is already written there. So in this way, we can translate a flow of control statements into 3 address code.